everyone, welcome back. Today we are diving into something that's critical for data security but often overlooked. Sensitivity labels in Microsoft Purview. If you've ever worried about sensitive information getting into the wrong hands, this video is for you. Data leaks, accidental sharing, misuse of confidential information. These are just some of the nightmares that businesses face when they don't properly manage their data. Sensitivity labels in Microsoft Purview provide an elegant, streamlined way to help you mitigate these risks. Without a solid labeling strategy, you open the door to potential breaches, regulatory fines, and damage to your brand's reputation. So, by the end of this video, you not only know why sensitivity labels are essential, but you also learn exactly how to set them up in Microsoft Purview and start protecting your data today. Let's dive in. Start with the basics. What are sensitivity labels? Sensitivity labels allow you to classify and protect data based on its sensitivity. Whether it's a top secret business plan, internal project files, or publicly available marketing content. Every type of information can have a label that dictates how it should be handled. By applying a sensitivity label, you can restrict who can access the document, whether it can be shared externally, or even if it can be printed. Think of them as digital watermarks. They stay with your content even if it leaves your organization. That's what makes sensitivity labels so enormous powerful. Now, why should you care about this? Why is this so important? Data breaches can lead to massive fines, legal troubles, and damage to your company's reputation. In the year of 2023 alone, data breaches cost companies an average of 4.4 million globally. And when personal or confidential data is leaked, the consequences are not just financial. Sensitivity labels are like insurance. They help prevent mistakes before they are happening. They protect confidential data, meet compliance requirements, and ensure your employees know exactly how to handle the documents that they work with. All right, now let's get practical. I'll show you how to create sensitivity labels in Microsoft Purview, step by step. Okay, so welcome in the Microsoft Purview portal. You can find this portal on purview.microsoft.com. Microsoft Purview is actually a suite of a couple of solutions. If we click on solutions over here, you can see all the solutions that are part of Microsoft Purview. For sensitivity labels, we go to information protection, as they are part of Microsoft Information Protection. Within Microsoft Information Protection, we have the sensitivity labels, but also the policies. And policies allow us to deploy our sensitivity labels to our tenant. If I click on sensitivity labels over here, you can see that I have three sensitivity labels applied on this tenant. One called public, for all public related information. One that's called internal, for all internal related information, which can only be accessed by people within my tenant. And one called classified, which is for classified information and can only be accessed by me. So, this is wide open. Everyone can view this information. And the higher our priority, the more classified the information gets and less users have access to it. So if I click on one of my labels, for example, the classified, we get all the properties of this label. We see the name, we see a description, we see the scope. We can apply this label to files, emails, but also meetings. There's access control enabled on it. There's no content marking. We don't have auto labeling configured. I will do a video on that soon. We don't have meeting settings. And there's no schematized auto labeling. If I click over here and click on edit label, we go to the panel where we can change all our stuff. So we also can give it a color so that our users can quickly identify with what label they are dealing with. If we go to scope, I have to click on next for that. We can configure the scope. If I click next, we go to items. So what do we want with this label? In this case, I would like to use the label for controlling access. So we control who can access and view the labeled items. If we go next, you can actually see how I have configured access control. So in this case, I have assigned this label to myself. Only the following persons have access to this content. If I click on next, I can configure auto labeling. We'll leave that right now. Here we can set up groups and sites. We'll leave that right now. We don't want schematized data assets now. And here we have the summary. If I now click on save label, it will get updated. So if we now have a look at our policies, if I click on policies and go to publishing policies, this is where I can publish my labels. And I have a label policy. I can click on this one. It will also show me the content. It has a name. It will publish some labels. It will set an admin unit. It will publish to Exchange email. And here we can configure all the default settings. So all documents generated on this tenant are by default labeled as internal. So if a user wants to share something to the public, he has to make a change to the label. If I click on edit, we can change all the stuff. I can add an admin unit if I would like so. I can determine to what users and groups I would like to publish this. In my case, I'll push this to everyone. And here I can set some configuration. For example, in this case, users must provide a justification to remove a label or lower its classification. If something is labeled as classified and all of a sudden one of the users changed the label to public, he has to give a justification. I could configure more options. For example, require users to apply a label to their emails and documents. If I configure this one, if someone creates a document or an email, he has to label it first before it can be saved or sent. I could also require users to apply a label to their Fabric and Power BI content. As I don't use Power BI in this tenant, I will leave this turned off right now. Provide users with a link to a custom help page. So I could forward my users to a custom help page where I explain more about my labels and what they contain. Here I can configure the settings, so the default label that is applied to documents. Here the default label that's applied to email. Here the default label that is applied to meetings. And here is the default label that is applied to Fabric and Power BI content. If I click on next, I can change the description over here, which is currently empty. And when I click finish, this will set up my policy. It's interesting for you to know when we create a new sensitivity label, we add it to our policy, or we create a new policy, it can take up to 24 hours before it's pushed to all our devices in our environment. So keep that in mind. Let's now have a look at what the user experience is. So I'm currently at the workstation of one of our users of the tenant. And if I open Word and start a new document, let's say this is an HR document, I'll type HR document. You can see on the top over here that our document is currently labeled as internal. We can see the description of the label over here. I can click on this one and I could change this to classified because this is HR, it's important, should never be leaked. The content is classified and restricted to limited users, is what the dialog says. That's exactly what we have configured over here. So if I now save this one, we have a classified document. For the following scenario, I would like to email my confidential document to someone outside of my organization. So if I open up Outlook, I click new email. Let's say I would like to send this to myself with the email address outside of this organization. And I will give it the subject HR document. And let's add the attachment. So if I would like to attach browser OneDrive, and let's go for the HR document. And quite easy, I can send this right now. We see that we also have a label over here. Let's send this one. Give it an okay, and it's now sent. So this is the current experience of a user outside of our information. This is a user that uses Google and don't has a Microsoft tenant. It doesn't even have a mail address in our tenant. So this is the experience. The email is not displayed. If I would like to read the message, I can click on the button over here and that will forward me to this page over here. I might click on sign on with a one-time passcode. So now Microsoft did send me a one-time passcode. Let's open that and copy paste it over here. Let's click on continue. I don't have permission to view this message. That's actually quite correct, as I'm not part of this organization. And the email was labeled internal, so only internal employees or accounts of the tenant can view this message. Now let's talk for a minute what happens if you're not taking this measurement and not implement sensitivity labels in your environment. If sensitive information like customer data or intellectual property leaks, not only are you facing potential financial losses, but regulatory bodies like the GDPR or CCPA could hit you with massive fines. Your reputation could take a hit, and your customers might lose trust in your ability to protect their data. In today's world, where data is the most valuable asset, can you really afford not implement these protections? So to sum it all up, sensitivity labels in Microsoft Purview give you control who sees, shares, or edits your documents. They protect your data and keep you compliant with regulations. Now that you know how easy it is to create and use them, it's time to put this in action. If you found this helpful, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and share this video with others who need to know about data security. Stay tuned for more insights on how to protect your business with Microsoft powerful tools. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in the next one. Bye!